A year has passed since the Chinese government announced the plan to establish Xiongan New Area on April 1, 2017. Deemed as a historic project, Xiongan is undergoing a rapid transformation to an eco-friendly, digital and intelligent city, setting a national model of quality development. Xiongan New Area is about 100 kilometers southwest of Beijing in Hebei Province. The new area is significant in terms of moving out institutions not essential for Beijing as capital city, exploring a new model of development in densely populated areas, restructuring the layout of the Beijing-Tianjin-Hebei region, and creating a new engine for China's modernized economy. The project of Xiongan's public service center is well known as the first building of Xiongan. The center will have many functions such as the government service, exhibition, conference, enterprise office, and so on. Remarkably, over 30 new technologies have been applied to the project, thus creating the Xiongan speed and Xiongan quality.
在不同的图纸上进行设计，和它一个模块上会发生一些碰撞。我们提前模拟这些碰撞，把这些问题消化在设计的一个前期，在具体做的过程中，避免了这种返工跟品质的降低。项目进行了闭幕全生命周期的应用，将闭幕技术与智慧建造系统相结合。在这个进度管理模块当中，我们可以看到。 我们左侧是一张这个虚拟进度图，然后我们的右侧是一个现场的实际进度。这样的话呢，对我们的这个现场的这个进度管理、施工管理，能够进行更直接、更全面的进行一个管控。我们专门在里面结合地下管廊的建设，建造了1.2公里的雨水管廊。
那么在旱季来可以用来进行绿化和这个其他景观的使用。New
technologies are to be widely used for efficiency promotion, environment protection, and energy conservation in project constructions. On February 28th, Beijing Xiongan Intercity Railway, the first major transportation project in Xiongan, started construction. The 33.5 billion yuan line stretches over 92 kilometers via Daxing District of Beijing and Bazhou City in Hebei Province and has 5 stops. Travel time between Beijing and Xiongan will be reduced to only 30 minutes.
那么我们这项目建成通车之后，可以极大地缩短京津冀城市间的时空距离，提高雄安新区通达性和辐射能力。
Xiongan now is seeing a reforestation project covering 100 million mu called Millennium Forest. Quite different from traditional forest construction, each tree planted there has its own unique identification card.
这是一个专门的软件，我们对这个手机这有 APP 嘛，然后打开，然后通过这扫一扫，然后呢对这个二维码进行扫描，然后呢它。 把我们这个二维码这棵树的地块、区域、名称都以及它的地理坐标都进行了标识。随着这个生态建设的持续，将来呢，我们这个对大数据系统里边的相应的苗木的一些规格、一些生长情况也要进行这个相关的录入。到那个时候呢，我们就可以通过大数据系统把我们平原地区这个森林的整个的构建。
China aims to turn the area into a low-carbon, intelligent, and globally influential city where people and nature exist in harmony. There's still a long way to go.